Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I have a January collective haul for you guys. I know the month of January is not over yet, but I don't think I'm gonna be buying anything soon. So I'm just gonna show you what I did buy for the month of January, and then if I buy anything else for the rest of the month, I'll put it in a collective haul for February. But let's just jump right into it. I'm gonna share with you guys, I guess, like the clothing and like fashion items that I bought, and then after I'll show you guys the miscellaneous stuff that I got this month. So the first item is a bag that I got, and it's very similar, or it's basically like the same type of bag that I received on Christmas. If you guys didn't see my last vlog, which is a Christmas vlog, on Christmas Day of Vlogmas, I did get a bag for my sister. It's an Adidas like little clip-on bag. It's like a little small mini bag, and it's camel print, but unfortunately that wasn't the right one that I wanted, even though I did put that on my list, but I didn't realize that it didn't come with a strap. So I saw this one on ASOS, and that one was from ASOS also. I saw this one on ASOS. It was originally like $37 and I only got it for $20. So I thought, let me just hurry up and get it because I really, really wanted it, and I kind of wanted to use it also as an everyday bag. So I didn't want to have the small one, but I'm still gonna use a small one if I'm like running somewhere real quick. But this one I kind of just wanted to carry around with me to work and whatnot, and it's a little bit bigger, which I kind of like. So it's this bag right here. It's just an Adidas. I think it's actually a fanny pack because the strap isn't as long. The strap was actually shorter than this. It was like right against it. So I think it is a fanny pack, but I can use it either way. I like it both ways. As for a strap, if I do it cross body, it's a little bit short, but I can just put it right over my shoulder and it feels fine. But I just like how it's really wide, but then short. Like, I don't know, I kind of like that style. It's really spacious inside, and it has a zipper in the front. And it just has the Adidas logo, and the strap also has camel on it. I don't know, I just thought it was a really nice bag and it looked really cool. So I'm gonna be rocking this all this year. I'm for sure that this is gonna be like my everyday go-to bag. So the next item is a sweater, and this is actually a thrifted sweater that I got off of Depop. I'm gonna try and leave the name of the Depop shop right here because I can't remember off the top of my head. I probably should have wrote it down. But this sweater I saw that she had listed on her shop, and it was originally like I think $35 or something. I don't remember, I'm not sure. And I was like, it looks really comfy and nice and good quality, but I don't know if I want to pay $35 for a sweater that's already been used. So I just kept it in my likes, and then I realized when I went back to it that she actually lowered the price, and I was so excited about that. So I think she lowered it to around 20 something. I don't remember, but I was like, okay, that's a reasonable price for that. So it's just this nice knit sort of, I forgot what this is called, a cable knit sweater. I think that's what it is. And it's like this nice tan color, like oatmeal color, maybe a little bit like more yellow. You can't really tell on the camera, but it's so thick, so warm. It fits so nice on me. It's not too oversized, not too small, and it's such like a great length. And I love this, and I've been wearing this non-stop, and it's super warm. So even if I like to layer like my turtlenecks underneath these kind of sweaters, I kind of get a little bit hot, but it's fine. I like the way it looks. It matches so many different things, and I'm gonna keep on rocking it until it gets hot outside where I can't wear it anymore. The next item is also from Depop, and it's from another Depop shop. I'll put them right here. And I saw one of these, my friend had one on, and it's really, really comfy. And I've heard of this brand, but I don't know why I didn't just go to the store and get it. I feel like the vintage ones are kind of better. You can kind of find different ones from like back in the day. So I found this one on this site. I'm kind of pleased with it a little bit. I just thought it was gonna be bigger because it did say on the shop that it was a woman's size large. So I thought it was gonna be like oversized on me, but it fits just perfectly. But it's this Patagonia fleece sweater, and it's kind of like the funnel neck looking one. It's really soft, really warm. It's not like the men's where it has like the zipper pockets. It has these little like, you just put your hand right in. And it has this little chest pocket, and then it says Patagonia right there. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it. But it has this nice light gray color with some purple detailing. I just thought that was really cute. And it even has purple detailing on the bottom. But it does kind of look small, and I kind of want it to be oversized. I might check some more out on Depop, see if there's any cool ones that's on there. Maybe a men's one, so it does fit oversized. But I'm still going to wear this. It's still a really cool color, and I don't know, I really like it. So the next two items are actually some jewelry pieces. One of them I got from Depop again, and then the other one I got from another jewelry store, but I'll show you guys the one from Depop first. So the first one is this little gold necklace. I want to show you guys up close. It's just this pendant that has an F on it because of my last name. I'm not gonna say my last name right here, but if you guys seen my Instagram, you probably see my last name. But it's just this cool little square pendant gold that just has an F in the middle. I just thought it was so dainty. I kind of wish I got a longer chain because I do have my nameplate necklace and they end up being the same exact length, and I wasn't sure exactly what length this one was. I probably should have measured, but I think I'm gonna go back and find a chain longer or shorter for this one, and then for the next necklace, get it longer. So this one's shorter and add the nameplate, and then I'll have the next one after it. This is really cute. I think it was about $18 and maybe $5 plus shipping. So it's around like $22, $23. But I'll put the seller's name right here. And I don't know, it's such great quality. And it is gold filled, so it won't turn my skin green because I have that problem with a lot of jewelry. The next necklace is from a seller named It's Iris Jewelry, or I think it's just called It's Iris. I'm not sure. I'm gonna leave her website in the link down below and also her Instagram and everything. But I saw her jewelry on someone that I followed on Instagram, and I just thought it looks so nice, and it's like I love gold jewelry, and she was having a lot of gold jewelry on her website. So I checked it out and I was like, these jewelry pieces are really dope. So I got another one that kind of looks like the one that I just showed you, but this one is actually a cross. So I'm gonna show you guys that up close. It's this cross, and as you can see, it has a little bit of engraving, some sort of design in there. And this is the same length, as I said, as the other one and as this necklace I have on now. So I do want to get a longer chain for this one, but I just thought this is really nice. But I think this is gold filled also, so this will be great for my skin and my body chemistry, making sure I don't turn my skin green. But yeah, and the reason I got the cross was because, you know, religious reasons. I'm not gonna get too into it because I know a lot of people are weird about that subject, but yeah, I just thought I'd get this one. It's really nice, and I'm definitely gonna be buying from her again. Now moving on to the miscellaneous items. I went to Barnes & Noble's the other day in the city just to wait for my sister because we were supposed to meet up to go somewhere, and then we were going to the movies. And I was just looking around, and I went to like the bestsellers section, and I saw this book, and I've been really into poetry books lately. And I found this one, which is actually, if you guys know Gabby Hanna on YouTube, I know she was on Vine first and then she became on YouTube. I didn't realize this was her. I didn't know that was her name. So I would just see her, and this is actually her poetry book. I think it is a poetry book. And it's called Adolescence, like adult lessons. And she actually wrote this book, of course, but she also illustrated the pictures that she has inside. And I'm like, dude, she's an amazing artist. I'm gonna call her artist because, dude, this is like some freaking art. So she actually drew all the pictures inside, and it's just a great, it's a very, like, it's about all the kind of things that a adult that's like a teen that's transitioning into an adult would like, and the things that you go through, whether it's like breakups or heartaches or even family problems or going through school problems. Like, she talks about all of that in here, and I don't know, I just love this book so much. I read it all in like one day, and it really got to my feels a little bit, but I do recommend this. She really did great on this, so props to her. And you guys should check it out also if you're really into like poetry and stuff. The next item I got is also a book, or I should say a magazine. And I was watching Orion's video, Orion Carlito, for those of you that don't know. And she, I think it was in her last favorites video, and she was mentioning this magazine. And this is the Kinfolk magazine, but this is issue 24, I believe, and it's the relationships issue. And I know Orion Carlito is also a writer, and she has her own book that I also saw in Barnes & Noble, so I was gonna pick it up, but wasn't ready yet. I didn't have the money on me, it's kind of broke. But in her favorites video, she does talk about this book, and she's very into writing like love poetry and stuff about relationships. So she recommended this book, with, or magazine I should say, I keep calling it a book, but I feel like it is. It actually has like an insert of like relationship sort of like things in here, plus just pictures of like fashion stuff. So I haven't got to reading around to it yet, but this is like an insert from the magazine. This one is about intimacy, then they have one about communication, and they have like two other ones. but I definitely need to start sitting down and reading this one. And this is about $18. I think I got it on Amazon rather than the website. But if you go on their website, you can see all the issues that they have based off of all different things. They have a food one, they have one about social media, a bunch of different topics that they have, but I'm really into relationship stuff, so that's why I got this one. And the last four items that I'm gonna share with you guys is some vinyls. I've been into my record player lately, and I have a few that I got with the record player back like 2 years ago, and I kind of got back into it, so I went on like a little spree. And there's only four records, but some vinyls cost quite a lot, so I call it a spree. But the first one I got is the White Stripes' Get Behind Me, Satan. I love this album so much. Like, I remember listening to White Stripes all the time, and I don't know, it just brought back memories when I played it again. You should definitely check them out. They're really great. It's kind of like a rock. Yeah, it is a rock band, but it's like I feel kind of like bluesy in there sometimes, some songs, and like not too hardcore rock. I don't know, just check it out. But I don't remember how much this was. I think it was around like 20 something, but great songs, and it's really great. The next one is also a favorite of a lot of people, and this is the Strokes' Angle album, and I love this album too. My number one favorite song is Machu Picchu, if that's how you say it. I know it's based off the place, Machu Picchu, but I don't know, I just love this one too. I was so excited when I found it. Just brings back memories of the time when I listened to this about like 4 years ago, like right after I graduated high school. But yeah, this one's also great. I believe this was about $18, which isn't too bad. So I'm kind of happy that I picked this one up also. The next one, I got this at Strand Bookstore. Those two I also got at Strand. And then the next one I'll show you after this one, I got at a different place. But this one I also got at Strand. And I remember when I was checking it out, the clerk said, oh my gosh, I was just looking at this vinyl. Like, he was so into it and saying it's like one of the best albums yet. And I decided to pick it up myself because I love them too. And I got the Daft Punk Discovery album. That's this Discovery, right? Yeah, it's Discovery, I'm sorry. See, I don't know. But this is like so great, such a classic. I love Daft Punk. It has like One More Time on it, if you guys didn't know, Harder, Better, Faster, Stronger. It has Veridisquo, if that's how you pronounce it. But I had to pick this up. It was about $25, $27, a little bit pricey for me, but this is such a great album and I just needed it. Like the sound of it, like, ugh, I just had to pick it up. And the last item and vinyl that I have to show you guys is one that you guys probably won't know, but it's actually a soundtrack to a movie. And this is based off of the movie, but this is from the movie To Sir With Love with Sydney Poitier. If you guys never watched this movie, it's a really great movie. It's like my aunt's and my mom's like favorite movie. It's from like the 1960s, I think, or 1970s, one of those times. But it has such a great, like, I don't know, it's a really nice classic sort of like album. Kind of reminds me of like French music in Paris, even though it's in English that they're singing. But this was only $8 at a place called Good Records NYC, I believe. I'm not sure. I'm gonna leave the link down below. It's located downtown in the city, if you're from New York. So you guys should definitely check that out. So yeah, this is a great find. I'm so happy I found it. And I'm definitely gonna be going back there and picking up some more because they have really great prices on some records. So guys, that is all the items that I had to share with you. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will leave all the links down below, of course, like I said, if you guys wanna check out any of these items. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and comment down below if you have any questions or if you have any requests for me to do more videos. And be sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you know when I upload a new video. I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!